Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's exciting Excel video, we're going to take a look at how to identify text versus numbers inside of one column. This question came from a professional MBA student. It was a great question. Column I has purchases to date. Column K has income. They both look like numbers or values. So here are five easy ways to identify if text is inside of your numbers. And the reason you'll want to know this is if text is inside those numbers, if I start doing formulas, my formulas would be incorrect. So method one is the icon actually shows up. It's that green rectangle. It says, hey, this is text. Should it be a number? If I come over here and click, you'll actually see what it says right there. And I can actually convert this to a number. But right now that 73,000 is text. I'm going to convert it. Method one, that was easy. Method one doesn't always appear, especially when you pull stuff from a database or from the web. Method two, I love this method. Whenever you select numbers in Excel, I'm actually going to select the first two. If you notice in the very bottom of my screen, that is called the status bar in Excel. Over in the very far left, it's got the word ready. And all the way in the very far right, it's got my zoom, which is at 130%. If you click just one number, I still get ready and I still have my zoom. But notice to the left of my three different views down here, there's nothing. The minute you highlight two numbers, sum, average, and count appear by default. That is already set up in Excel. Here are two things I recommend you turn on. Highlight them. There's sum, average, and count. That count that you see is actually count A. It's counting any cell that's not blank. So it's not counting numbers, it's counting anything that's not blank. My header row is row 1 and it stops at 25, so 24 is correct. But I know I've got text in here, so if I right click, I would always turn on numerical count. Now look, so I've got what appears to be 24 text or numbers, that's the count, but the numerical count is 19, so there's 5 cells that are clearly text in here that do not appear as text. And the reason you want to fix this is if I do the sum function, cell I2 through I25, that is incorrect. Control single apostrophe will copy whatever function you have above it down. Average, 992. Those two numbers are incorrect, and if I continued with functions, they would be incorrect. So method three for identifying them, there's method two. Oh, by the way, I told you I would have some other stuff checked. I always turn on maximum and minimum, so it's actually three things I recommend you come in here and turn on inside this little group from average down to sum. Notice they got these little lines above them. I would turn on maximum and minimum. They're on forever. Not just this worksheet, not just this file. They're always on. Okay, method three, I'm going to come over here and do the function isNumber. And isNumber will decide if it's a number or not and give you true or false. Get your crosshairs and just double click. So you can see anything that's false, and I should have 5 of those. Those are my texts. Opposite of isNumber almost is there's a function called isText, and that's going to tell you if something is text or not. So it's just the opposite. So now I should have 5 trues, and I do. And one last one. There's actually a couple other ways in here, by the way. I'm just trying to keep this easy. This is one of my favorites. If you actually want to see them without the true and false, that was actually pretty cool. Highlight your range. In this example, I'm going to be real specific. I selected from I2 down to I25, but I2 was the first cell that I selected. On the Home tab, we have conditional formatting, and let's write a new rule. This is going to be really simple. I'm going to use that equals is text function that I just showed you. I2. Go to format, put a background fill color on it. I don't care what color you pick. I'm going to pick orange. Click OK. Click OK. I should get 5 numbers that are text numbers. There you go. By the way, watch this. Text. I'm using the control key to select all 5. Look down in the bottom right corner also. It can't do sum and average and max and all that because it's text. So it says count 5. So I've got 5 text cells selected. If I come in here and select a bunch of number cells, now everything's working. Anyway, I hope that helps. And you see why it's so important that you change the text to numbers. By the way, real quick, look at my numbers down at the bottom. 18, 851, 992, 500, 440. The conditional formatting is going away also. 2530, 310. There you go. In real life, bonus tip. And bonus tip is this. A couple other ways to change these. I'm going to make a video on this, but I could have done the value function. Equals value, it converts everything to value. 18, 851, I'm going to paste values. 23, 181, highlight, one more test. Numeric count, 24, count 24, I use the value function. I'm going to make a whole nother video on how to convert text to numbers. There's easier ways than the one I just did, even though that was really simple. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you for the question from the professional MBA student. That was a great question. Led to this video. Thank you.